Hola, bienvenidos a la clase de Español 1. All right, so today we're going to go over Gustar Advanced. You should have watched the Gustar video beginner that I have posted earlier. So today we're going to go over everything that we did in class today. So we're going to learn how to agree with somebody that you like something. We're going to agree with somebody that you don't like something. We're going to add a name to our don't like sentences or our do like sentence. Now that we know how to use the Gustar formula, we're going to transfer our knowledge to a whole bunch of other verbs. It's kind of like an exclusive list that you can use with the Gustar formula, and you'll love it. Of everything in that is not green, you already know. So we're now just going to add the emphasis. For example, I don't like something at all, or I really like something. We've learned how to say that normally, but now we're adding emphasis. So I'm going to say everything, and you are going to say it with me, especially the second time. So when we turn in speaking assignments in class, you'll be so used to speaking Spanish with me that you won't be nervous at all. No me gusta nada cantar. No me gusta nada cantar. So you notice the nada is the at all. In the last chapter, we learned that nada means nothing. So it's kind of like saying, I don't like to sing for nothing. Let's go to the next one. No me gusta nada la música rock. No me gusta nada la música rock. I'll slow down a little bit because you're probably trying to speak with me and I'm going a little bit fast. So the next one is emphasis, but in a positive way. I really like to dance instead of just I like to dance. Me gusta mucho bailar. Me gusta mucho bailar. Well, in English, we usually use neither or nor. For example, I like neither gray nor purple. So now let's look at it in a sentence. We have Raul. He doesn't like neither the shoes nor the sandals. In English, we're used to saying, don't use a double negative. For example, in English, I don't have nothing to say. Don't and nothing are double negatives. But actually here in Spanish, here's an opportunity for you to use your double negatives. And this is actually a triple negative. Here we go. Everything in green is negative. So say it with me twice. A Raúl no le gusta ni los zapatos ni las sandalias. A Raúl no le gustan ni los zapatos ni las sandalias. Now let's try to figure out the second one. I bet you can. No nos gusta ni escribir cuentos ni leer revistas. Okay, what does it mean? It doesn't please us neither writing stories nor reading magazines. No nos gusta ni escribir cuentos ni leer revistas. No nos gusta ni escribir cuentos ni leer revistas. What if two people like something, like fish? So one person would say, I like it. Me gusta. Me gusta. Then what if somebody wants to agree with them? I like it too. A mí también. A mí también. So now, what if two people don't like something? Balloon animal. So you would say, no me gusta. No me gusta. And then what would the person agree with you? I don't like that balloon animal either. So you would say, a mí tampoco. A mí tampoco. So two people are agreeing they don't like something. The two things we just looked at, let's put them in sentences. One person says, me gusta bailar, me gusta bailar. And the response is, a mí también me gusta bailar. A mí también me gusta bailar. So I like dancing too. So one person says, le gustan los deportes. Le gustan los deportes. He or she likes sports. And the other person says, a mí también, a mí también. Nos gusta trabajar en la escuela. Nos gusta trabajar en la escuela. We like working at school. It pleases us to work at school. And then the other person says, we like working at school too. A nosotros también. A nosotros también. So now let's look at negative. One person says, no me gusta bailar. No me gusta bailar. I don't like to dance. And then the person says, a mí tampoco. A mí tampoco. I don't like to dance either. So what does that look like in a longer sentence? A mí tampoco me gusta bailar. A mí tampoco me gusta bailar. common error is to put a no right here. Except here, think about it in English. I don't like dancing either. You only heard one negative. So on your viewing guide, write in the answers for these three and pause it, and then you'll be able to see the answers. No me gusta esquiar. No me gusta esquiar. No nos gusta montar en bicicleta. No nos gusta montar en bicicleta. You will see that it says we don't like to ride bikes. This often means we don't like bicycling. So it says the students don't like to dance. So dancing does not please the student. A los estudiantes no les gusta bailar. A los estudiantes no les gusta bailar. There is a way to do the sentences where you add us. We don't like catfish. So see how, like, I'm making emphasis on me? No, I don't like scary movies. Instead of just saying, I don't like scary movies, or we like catfish. And it's really easy to do. So you would just add this to the beginning of the sentence. Don't like something? Me? I don't like catfish. So you would add this at the beginning. A mí no me gusta. And then you would put the catfish. Person's name here. A mi mamá no le gusta el chicle. She doesn't like gum. What are the verbs that work exactly like gustar? They have the same formula, the same format, and once we learn this formula, we can transfer our skills to other verbs. You'll see that on the next slide. So let's look at the one that we actually have in Spanish 1. It's called encantar, and it doesn't mean to like, because remember, we talked about gustar to like. This is like one level above. It looks like enchant, doesn't it? So you're saying, well, I really love this. It enchants me, right? So I love mangoes. Me encantan los mangoes. So the mangoes enchant me. All right, so think about something that you love. How would we put that into a sentence? Think about, is it single or is it plural? For example, if you like cake, see how that's single? That would go over here, single noun. Plural. Like oranges. Well, now you have plural now. Here we have me encanta la clase. Me encanta la clase. I love that class. Te encantan los mangoes. Te encantan los mangoes. The mangoes enchant you, or you love the mangoes. So here's our last one. Me duele is when something aches you. So let's think about body parts. Well, you have two eyes, so that would be plural. You have one nose, one head, one mouth. So that would be single. So here we go with the single body part. So here we have, me duele la cabeza. So what hurts you? The head, right? And you're like, the head? Why not my head? Because it's clear that you own that body part. And so you don't have to say that that body part is yours. Here we have, te duelen las piernas. So the legs hurt you. They're your legs, so you don't have to say they're your legs. The legs, they hurt you. So here is a list of the verbs that work exactly like gustar. They are the same plan. They are the same formula. For example, to bore, that bores me. That enchants me. That's missing. That fascinates me. That's important. That interests me. That bothers me. And that fits me. Bye, guys.